I had a wrap my first day there, of course, because I moved in and then your parents leave and then that's it. And so right after lunch, I ate their horrible lunch and then we went into wrap and nobody prepared me for wrap. And I went into an older student's wrap and immediately they just started going off. Like this one girl literally almost ran across the room and hardly sitting in her chair. And she's like, okay, so and so, I've just got to clean up with you that you're totally out of agreement. And then they start yelling at each other and screaming and spits coming out of their mouth. And then after that, like three guys, these are guys, dudes, just start screaming at the floor, like with their arms wrapped around the chairs, screaming and yelling at the floor, snot flowing out of their mouth, out of their nose. Their faces are bright red. Some people busted vessels in their eyes and their faces were all puffy. You always knew who took care of their feelings. They had puffy faces. And I was in shock. I mean, I think I spent the first 2 weeks just in complete and total shock, dude.
In my first rap or my second rap, I saw what would become a familiar sight, but what was really, really shocking to me. I saw a girl my age, maybe 16, she might have been 17, very attractive girl, very handsome features, lovely, articulate girl, bending over and leaning her head between her knees and yelling a bit. And then screaming a bit, and then mostly talking in an extremely loud voice about some terrible, I couldn't quite get it, but some terrible things that had happened. I wasn't sure what they were. And there was some language I didn't understand about my me or my little child. I didn't get it. And then she started crying. She didn't cry like if, I don't know how to describe it. You know, when a child cries, like an infant, and they wail and they use every part of their lung, you know, that loud, but in an adult's body, she's just exploding with this, you know, and it just doesn't stop. And it's this girl sitting two or three chairs away from me in this circle of chairs, and I'm looking at her, and she starts to, her sinus is empty. I mean, her sinus is empty. And what you think you know about snot, you do not know. Her sinus is empty, and this mucosal stuff, it's like a clear kind of elastic pudding, starts to flow out of her nose and flows, and it runs, and you can see bubbles in it. And then she takes a breath in and exhales, and it, she blows like a football-sized bubble, like a Nerf ball-sized bubble in the snot. And I just watch it going toward the ground and hitting this pile of tissues, and it just, there's a giant bubble. I don't know what it is. There's a giant mucus bubble, maybe that big on the ground, on this pile of tissues. And the adult in the room is saying, "That's right, Lauren, that's right. How does that make you feel? What does that do to your little girl? This, that, the other thing." And
I think my second or third rap, I figured out that I was supposed to do that stuff too, that I was supposed to run my anger and that I would have to share about myself and that I would have to take care of my feelings with these people and everybody watching. I couldn't believe it. I mean, who comes up with something like that?
You just get in there and you sit down in the circle, you find your seat and you wait and you wait and you see if anybody talks to you. And if nobody talks to you, you start talking to whoever gets talked to first. Because you don't want anybody on your back. And the best way to keep people from talking to you is talk to other people. And what is it to talk to other people? It's not like, hey, how you doing?
What I remember was people sort of ganging up and talking to somebody about stuff that the person was doing that wasn't okay. Either inappropriate or maybe some actual event, you know, that yesterday when you did this, you know.
There's like 10 people in this rap and somebody starts talking to somebody else, you know. I was on a work cruise with you the other day and you were completely slacking off. I didn't see you working. And remember, the staff didn't pay any attention, so you could get away. People lied. I mean, I've told people this. I feel like CDU trained us to lie because we got rewarded for lying in raps a lot. You got lots of rewards for lying in raps. Because so now I'm sitting there and I'm thinking, okay, so she's talking to her about slacking off. I'm not in her peer group. I wasn't on work cruise with her that day. I wasn't there, but I saw him the other day doing something that didn't look quite right. So I'm going to get across the room and I'm going to say, yeah, and you know what else? I saw you talking to so-and-so. Aren't you on bans from her? No, I'm not on bans from her. What do you mean? I thought you were on bans from her. At least a week ago, you were on bans from her. I'm sure of it. No, I wasn't on bans from her. And then somebody's moved on. It doesn't even matter what you said. Somebody else has gone across the room and say, oh yeah, and you know what? When you were on dinner dishes with me, I had to totally pull your weight because you didn't do shit. And like, it just, you know, especially if they're on a full-time, if somebody's on a full-time, everybody's like, oh good, somebody on a full-time is in the rap because we know we can blow their ass away for like at least 45 minutes and that's going to eat up some time because you just don't want that gun pointed at you. So you keep it pointed at other people.
5, 6, 7, 8 people fighting to cross the room just so that they could yell at you and tell you what a monster you were and what an asshole you were and how you're not getting it and how you have like all these issues. And I'm talking about being yelled at for over an hour straight.
An hour, hour and a half. It just seems like 3 hours that you'd be getting yelled at. You were on the hot seat. You know, it was like a lot of times you had to come up with the right answer or it's just going to go on and on and on and on.
Sometimes they would just start yelling at you, to try to make you to cry. Like, I would be getting yelled at stuff that didn't apply to me sometimes. And I think that they were just, like, some of the staff were just hoping it would trigger something in me. The few times that I did cry in raps, it was because I was being yelled at by, like, an adult and I was intimidated, not because they really tapped into anything that was, like, emotionally relevant to my life. But then I would start crying and then they would start leaving me alone thinking I'm making this progress, but really I was crying because I was like horrified that I got sent away from home and this like grown man was like yelling at me that I had never met before. So
I mean, they could get absolutely downright hurtful. It absolutely crushes and demeans you and makes you feel like you're about that big.
No. And whether it was a faculty member or another student, they would come right at you and just keep coming at you, never let go until they said, okay, until the faculty said, let's move on, or you get so beat down into a pulp that you get into your feelings, which I always had a hard time with because of the fact for so many times I was told I'm faking it, that I could never trust. And I still, to this date, have trouble being able to say, okay, this is how I feel and this is okay. But because I was told back then, I don't have tears, so I'm faking it, or I'm faking the tears. I would be instantly taken right out of my feelings and then they would say, let's move on.
Then you sit there and by the end of the rap, if there's 45 minutes left in that rap, you will get 5 people across the room from you. How come you haven't said one thing in this rap? You will get blown away for not saying anything in a rap. And you could do everything right. You could follow every agreement. You could do every single thing that you're supposed to do. You stay silent in a rap, you will get your ass blown away. And there is nothing like getting blown away. People don't understand in the real world, people who haven't been into the CDU, they don't know what it's like to have 15 people consecutively changing seats to get across from you to scream at you about what a piece of shit you are. I mean, it's really powerful stuff. It will make you believe that you're a piece of shit. It really will.
There was an understanding that the school was about challenging, you know. It wasn't just to have smooth times. Like, you had to stir the person up, you know. There was some kind of an underlying understanding that that's valuable, and we need to do this right. So when things get too easy, that's of no value. That's just a vacation. So let's keep that person stirred up.
And so like you get out of there and you're like, fuck, man, I'm a fucking piece of shit, man. Fuck, and they all said it and they all knew it and they had examples and. God, I'm fucking screwed. What am I gonna do? I'm such a piece of shit. I'm gonna fail. I'm never gonna be able to do anything. I'm one of those losers. I'm gonna end up on the street. I've got no self-control. I'm totally fucked.
I mean, that's the premise of the school, you know, like stir things up, you know. Don't let it get too easy. don't let it get too comfortable.